We often speak about Google reviews and building up your Google reviews on Google My Business. And you'll know this channel has done a lot to try and help you to do that. But how about getting those reviews now that you've built up and putting them onto your business website? Is there an easy way to do that? Well, in the past, it was quite complex. You had to get API credentials involved. You had to set up an account with Google. You even had to give your details for payment options in case they charged. But there's a plugin that's made that all a lot easier. In fact, with just one click and a look at your code, you can have that up and running on your website. Google reviews are a really important way or a big factor in building trust with those clients that have come across your business for the first time. So let's just imagine it. This person knows nothing about you, but they go to your website and there they see 50 or 60 people giving great reviews about your service or your products. Won't that help them to build trust in then actually parting with their well-earned money and going with you above others? Well, yes, it does. It has a massive effect according to all the studies that are made. These reviews from real people are the best way in which people can build up a complete picture about what type of service they'll get if they do business with you. Bright Local did a survey and they found that 84% of local people will trust those business reviews that they see on Google My Business. So to have them on your website, that's a huge ability to build up trust. And a study was done that the majority of people will look at 10 reviews before making their final decision. So if you've got some reviews on your website, you are putting yourself in a good position to be found. Now, if you're new to this channel, then thank you for joining me. Do make sure you subscribe because we discuss several ways on a weekly basis to see how we can improve your business, particularly within Google ranking. Another reason why Google reviews are so useful is because you can't control those reviews. Those reviews are coming from other people with their own Google accounts. So you have no control over what's being shown on those reviews on your website. They're dynamically produced. Whereas, of course, if you put your own testimonials on your website, then you could get anyone to write that. There's no proof of the credentials behind those reviews. So that's why Google reviews are so important to have on your website. So let's jump straight in and I'll show you how you can do this with one simple plugin. So next, what you need to do is now get your Places ID. All you need to do is type in your customer, or in this case, I've put the artist, Michael Hemming Artist. Just get the knowledge panel up and then just simply click, right click, inspect. And what you're doing is you're looking in the source code for four letters, C-H-I-J. So if you do Control F and you can search for a string down here, and if you put in C-H-I-J, and you're just looking for the data PID C-H-I-J. So it'll appear probably a few times, but that's what you're after. You copy that and that is your place ID. That's all you need. So I've logged into WordPress and I'm now going to search for, it's called Widget for Google Reviews. That's what you're after. Just search for that. And this is then the plugin that I use. You can see it's got good ratings as well. So it seems pretty up together. There's quite a few others. You may want to try others if you want, but this is the one that I've used and found pretty good. I'm going to activate it. So first of all, you get that CHIJ place ID. It reminds you there it's CHIJ, so I'm just going to put that in. And that will check to see now for the business. Yes, it's picked it up. It's picked up the right business. That proves that that was the right ID. So that's great. So let's connect to it. You can now see that these are Mike's reviews coming up as well. And how you view them, how you show them, again, you can see there's various ways to do that. So you can select which one would suit your selection rather than a sidebar. But there's a lot to choose from here. So you pick which one fits your layout. We're going to go for this one. And now you can select the style. Again, we've gone for minimalism throughout the website. So I think minimalism is probably the way to go. But I think a nice, simple layout would be the best. Now we're going to set the widget up. So do we want to filter ratings? No, we want it in English. Select date format, so kind of stick it to UK format. Hide reviews without comments, show reviewers photos. So you've got a lot of options here. We'll save and get code. And now we can just copy that, go to the page that we want it on, which is the About page. We edit that. And now we view the page. There you go. And we've now got those reviews as well. So we could just put a heading on here, take a look at our reviews. It's probably what I would do. So let's just go back to that. Take a look at some of our reviews, and then you've then got the 4-star reviews. And if people wanted to check out a bit more information, they can then just go on to any of these reviews, like read more, and they get the full information. And these will pull them in gradually as more reviews get added to the Google reviews for Michael Hemmings. That's how easy it is to get reviews on the site. So as you can see, in 2021, these plugins now are getting far easier. They're making it far easier for business owners and WordPress owners to just update their reviews by just a simple plugin. And you can add that whether it's on your footer, on your side panel, or whether you put it within the content of your WordPress website. But the one thing to do is to make sure that you do use it, especially if you've got some great reviews to show off. But if you want to know how to get some great reviews in the first place and how to get 5-star reviews on your business, then join me on this. You're going to love this video because it's going to help you do just that.